Hi, welcome to the fifth episode of The Electric Playground, a show that will take you inside the world of video games like no other channel has ever done before. I'm your host, Noah, and thanks for tuning in. For this fifth episode, we're going to conclude my favorite tracks from the Tekken series. This time, we're going to be listening to my favorite tracks from the second saga, Tekken 4, Tekken 5, Tekken 6, and Tekken Tag Tournament 2. Tekken 4, released in 2001 for the arcades and 2002 for the PlayStation 2, Tekken 4 is considered to be the least critically successful game in the series among fans and critics. However, I feel that this game was the best in the series for a number of reasons. For one, the game introduced many nuances and significant new gameplay changes to the game. For the first time, players were able to maneuver their characters around an arena, interacting with breakable walls, pillars, and other obstacles for extra damage. This was the first and only Tekken game to feature elevated and multi-tiered arenas, where characters may fight on a flat surface, but will find themselves fighting on top of a stairway, toppling their opponents down. It also introduced wall damage and ceiling damage, where characters can be shoved, punched, or kicked against a wall for damage, or if a character is launched in the air, they'll bounce off the ceiling. It also featured a switch maneuver for all characters, which lets players escape from being cornered and throw the tide in their favor. Tekken 4 was the first game in the series that focused on the stories of the individual characters, giving them a backstory like a prologue of the events that happened in previous games and the reasons as to why they're returning after a long hiatus and why they're entering the fourth King of Iron Fist tournament. These segments were narrated and displayed incredible artwork. Some contained graphic scenes such as a dead corpse, blood, violence, and partial nudity, a first in the series. Other than the massively improved graphics, Tekken 4 was the first and only game to introduce dialogue-heavy character endings that evoke the emotions of the characters. The endings of later games have been major disappointments. Comparing one of the characters, Kazuya Mishima, Tekken's 4 ending and Tekken 6 ending is a stark reminder of the lack of confidence Namco suddenly seems to have when it comes to the story of the later games. Tekken 4 also had a very dark, gritty, and mature presentation, not only present in the story, but also present in the subtle and casual sound of the score. Namco tried and experimented with many new things with the characters, not only in costume design, but also the dark and realistic nature of the story arcs. For instance, Martial Law battling alcoholism after his son was hospitalized and his restaurant goes out of business, and Paul Phoenix suffering from severe depression. It's time for Tekken to take itself seriously again. Now, the first track we're going to listen to from Tekken 4 is called Authentic Sky. Authentic Sky was the theme for the rooftop building arena. Tekken 4 was the only game in the series that allowed players to select a location within the arena to fight, since the arenas were massive. Rooftops located in New York City had many dynamic elements such as elevated floors, breakable statues, and walls, all of which showcased the many ways to pummel the opponent. Composed by Sotaro Kosaki, this is Authentic Sky.
Thank you.
And that was Authentic Sky. Now, I do apologize if you couldn't hear that track. We've been having some issues in the studio lately. But let's move on. The next song is called Kitsch. Kitsch was the theme for the beach arena located in the sandy beaches of Brazil. Fighters can fight in the ocean, knock their opponents into palm trees, and shove their enemies into concrete walls with graffiti. Composed by Yu Miyake, this is Kitsch. That was Kitsch from Tekken 4. Now the next song is called Bit Crusher. This arena takes place in between many buildings on the streets of Shinjuku, Tokyo, Japan. There are some telephone booths and people walking into various buildings. An opponent can be thrown or kicked into a telephone booth. For some reason, this arena reminds me of Kamurocho from the Yakuza series. Composed by Sutaro Kosaki, this is Bit Crusher. And that was Bit Crusher. Up next is Touch and Go. Touch and Go was the theme for the airport arena, where stationary airplanes surround the arena. It is actually possible to launch the opponent into the wing of the airplanes for extra damage. Composed by Sutaro Komaki, this is Touch and Go. And that was Touch and Go from Tekken 4. Up next is Tekken 5. Released in 2004 for the arcades and 2005 for the PlayStation 2, Tekken 5 marks the 10th anniversary of the series. It had a major expansion update called Tekken 5 Dark Resurrection that featured new gameplay tweaks, balancing, and additional content. This was the first Tekken game that was competitive in many tournaments all over the globe. Tekken 5 is credited for taking the series back to its original roots, completely ignoring some of the nuances of Tekken 4, as it incorporates a faster and more fluid fighting system, returning classic characters and some of Tekken's trademark infinite stages. This was the only game in the series to include cutscenes before fighting the character's rival. To celebrate its 10th year anniversary, the PlayStation 2 version contained all three arcade versions of Tekken 1, Tekken 2, and Tekken 3. This was the first Tekken game in the series to include customization items for the characters. It was an aesthetic feature which didn't affect the gameplay. This game was met with an overwhelming positive response, winning awards all over the world as the best fighting game ever made for the PlayStation 2. The first song we're going to hear from Tekken 5 is called Moonlit Wilderness. This takes place in a grassy field set at night during a full moon. An abandoned castle is located in the center of the arena, and various trees and plants surround the characters. This is one of the many infinite stages in the game where there are no boundaries or walls. This arena was remade in the latest installment of Tekken Tag Tournament 2. Composed by Sotaro Kosaki, this is Moonlit Wilderness. And that was Moonlit Wilderness. Up next is Streetwise. The arena, Acid Rain, takes place in Seoul, South Korea, as a sign in the arena is written in Hangul. Old buildings and metal fences surround the fighters. Acid Rain falls into the arena and onto the characters, hence the arena's name. And it was sort of funny to see a arena located in South Korea, because I'm half Korean, so it was pretty interesting to see how Tekken's interpretation of South Korea actually is in the game. Composed by Sotaro Kosaki, this is Streetwise. That was Streetwise. Up next is Call of the Inferno. Call of the Inferno, or City's Lights, is an arena in Tekken 5 Dark Resurrection, corresponding to the original Tekken 5's City at Sunset. The arena takes place in a rooftop of a bowling alley, as there are bowling pin decorations surrounding the arena. Composed by Keiichi Okabe, this is Call of the Inferno.
We'll be right back.
That was Call of the Inferno. Up next is All Hallows Eve. All Hallows Eve is an arena in Tekken 5 Dark Resurrection corresponding to the original Tekken 5's Secret Garden. This arena is set in a Halloween-themed setting with pumpkins on the ground, webbed gates, and brightly lit decorations surrounding the fences. Now, since last night was Halloween, I felt that this score goes well with the theme of post-Halloween. Composed by Nobuyoshi Sano, this is All Hallows Eve. That was All Hallows Eve. The next song is Snow Castle. Considered to be one of the many greatest tracks in the series, Snow Castle is an arena in Tekken 5 Dark Resurrection, corresponding to Tekken 5's Cathedral. This arena was remade in the latest installment of Tekken 2, one of my personal favorite tracks. Composed by Masaru Shina, this is Snow Castle.
Oh,
And that was Snow Castle from Tekken 5 Dark Resurrection. Oh, it's one of my favorite tracks. The time now is 9:42 p.m. It's Friday, November 1st. So for all you gamers out there, in 2 weeks, the PlayStation 4 will be available in GameStop and in other retail outlets. So be sure to pre-order yours right now. Temperature right now is 61 degrees Fahrenheit. It's been raining the whole day today, so I hope that if you're still driving, please be careful, as it might still be drizzling a bit. So up next is the PSAs, but unfortunately, a lot of things here in the studio is not really working, so here's a PSA of my own. Get yourself a PlayStation 4 or pre-order an Xbox One. And the question for you guys for this week is, which system are you going to be getting, the PlayStation 4 or the Xbox One? Okay, up next is Tekken 6, released on the arcades in 2007 and for the first time ever on the PlayStation 3, PSP, and Xbox 360 in 2009, Tekken 6 was a next-generation installment that hardcore fans had been waiting for. Initially, Namco planned on releasing Tekken 6 as a PlayStation 3 exclusive early in its development, but because so many fans requested that the series should go multi-platform, this was the first game in the series to be made available on Microsoft's Xbox. Tekken 6 featured similar gameplay mechanics to Tekken 5, but introduced several new features that enabled newcomers of the series to enjoy. Bound was a feature where it enabled players to easily juggle their opponents, and a rage system which activates if a player's health drops at a certain point. The idea of rage is that it could potentially change the outcome of a match by significantly increasing the damage. Tekken 6 introduced 6 new characters, and it's the second game in the series to have the largest amount of characters, over 40 characters in total. Although the gameplay added more depth from Tekken 5, this was when the fighting mechanics started to show its age. The game itself was well received by critics and fans, but because Tekken 5 set the bar in terms of content, most fans were disappointed that Tekken 6 didn't have a lot to offer in terms of side content. Temple Grounds. This was the only arena in Tekken 6 that featured day-to-night transitions and implementation of breakable walls, a feature that returns from Tekken 4. By breaking through the wall, the arena expands even further, allowing players to maneuver their characters in a bigger space. This theme sounds awfully similar to the Prodigy Spitfire, so I suggest you listen to that after listening to this track, and you'll see what I mean. Composed by Ryuichi Takada, this is Temple Grounds. That was Temple Grounds from Tekken 6. Up next is Tekken Tag Tournament 2. Released in the arcades in 2010 and the consoles in 2012, Tekken Tag Tournament 2 is the long-awaited sequel to the original Tekken Tag. Utilizing similar gameplay mechanics from Tekken 6, this game brings back a lot of familiar faces as well as a lot of surprises. This game has the largest amount of characters in the series, with over 50 characters to choose from. This is also a trivia as well, because in the console version of Tekken Tag Tournament 2, they added console-exclusive characters which weren't available on the arcade in the arcade release, as well as additional arenas as well. It also supported a very, very strong netcode, and many players were very, very happy with the netcode as well, because netcode is something which is very, very important in fighting games. So the song that we're going to be listening to is Nightfall. Nightfall is the theme played during the credits sequence. This is also one of my favorite tracks from the game. Composed by Taku Inoue, this is Nightfall. Was Nightfall from Tekken Tag Tournament 2. Now up next, we're going to be playing another song from Tekken 5. This is a bit of an impromptu. This is one of my favorite tracks. It's called Ground Zero Funk. This is the final arena in Tekken 5 where the prominent characters faced off in the final boss. Ground Zero is set in a desolate arena where there are many moody clouds surrounding the characters. And, of course, like I mentioned before, this is one of my favorite tracks from the game. A lot of fans also really, really love this track as well. So I hope you enjoy. This is composed by Keiichi Okabe, Ground Zero from Tekken 5. We'll be right back. And that's a wrap. Hope you enjoyed today's conclusion of Tekken Tag Tournament 2, Tekken 6, Tekken 5, and Tekken 4. Here's a little news for you, if you are a Tekken fan. Tekken Revolution is available on the PlayStation Network. So, and that's a free-to-play game. So make sure you download that game because it's free of charge. And every couple of weeks or so, Namco always adds new characters, adds some balanced changes to the game, you know, tweaking some variables with the damage and whatnot. So for all of you Tekken hardcore fans, or for those who are new to the Tekken series, please download Tekken Revolution. It will really help the download-wise, as well as hopefully we'll see a Vita version at some point. All right, hope you guys enjoyed. This is Noah signing off. Good night, everybody. Take care.